ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादे पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरतुसे नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंदा। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा। तो वी वेलकम एवरीवन फॉर टुडेज डिस्कशन ऑन श्रीमद् भगवद गीता द मैनुअल ऑफ लाइफ। सो यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड फ्रॉम भगवद गीता चैप्टर 1 एंड वर्स नंबर 15, पांचजन्यम ऋषिकेशो देवदत्तम धनंजया पौंड्रम दधमो महासंघम भीमकर्मा विकोदरः। लॉर्ड कृष्ण ब्लू हिज कॉन्शेल कॉल्ड पांचजन्य, अर्जुन ब्लू हिज द देवदत्ता, एंड भीमा द वोरेशियस ईटर एंड परफॉर्मर ऑफ हरकुलियन टास्क ब्लू हिज टेरिफिक कॉन्शेल कॉल्ड पौंड्रम। सो इन दिस वर्स the names of different conchal used by Pandavas and the Supreme Lord Krishna have been mentioned. So Krishna's conchal is Panchajanya. It has got a history how Krishna got it. Actually, Panchajanya eternally belongs to the Supreme Lord. Panchajanya is an eternal associate of Krishna. It's not just some dead material object. Panchajanya. Shankha, as we know in this material world, Shankha is made up of the bones of a living entity. So, but Panchajanya is actually a living entity itself, a personality. Panchajanya Prabhu. Panchajanya Prabhu is a very great devotee of Krishna. Krishna personally always blows this Panchajanya conchal. We can just imagine how fortunate must be this great devotee Panchajanya, because Krishna personally blows him using his lotus lips, the lips from which this so beautiful sound vibration comes in. He plays his flute, and which is desired by the damsels of Brajbhumi. The same Lord Krishna, he blows this conch shell, Panchajanyam. So he is Panchajanyam Prabhu. So Rishikesh blew his conch shell, Panchajanyam. Rishikesh means the master of the senses. And Dhananjay Arjuna blew his conch shell, Devadattam. And Bhima, Bhima Karma Vrikodara. Bhima, who is voracious eater, he blew his conch shell, Paundra. So we discuss this verse. We'll read the purport and discuss more about it. So Lord Krishna is referred to as Rishikesh in this verse because he is the owner of all senses. This we discussed yesterday. Krishna has been addressed in this verse as Rishikesha because Rishikesha means owner, master of all the senses, and Krishna is master of all the senses because he is Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the source of everything. Everything which is in this material world and spiritual world emanates from the Supreme Lord Krishna. Janamadiyasyatah in Vedanta Sutra, in the first sutra of the Brahma Sutra, Vedanta Sutra, this is explained. Janamadiyasyatah. And that also becomes the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Janamadeyasya yataha itarato vanyasya In this way, the first verse of Bhagavatam starts, Janmadi Yashyatah. Everything emanates or comes out from the Supreme Lord. That's why whatever is there in this material world, naturally, the Lord becomes the proprietor or owner or director or master of everything. So if Krishna is master or director, proprietor of everything, so naturally he is director or master of senses also. Not only just senses, but this entire body belongs to Krishna. We also belong to Krishna. Our master is also Krishna. This body's master is also Krishna. The senses master director is also Krishna. So it is very much appropriate that these senses, our body and senses, they should be used for the service of the Lord. This is not something which Krishna is demanding in the Bhagavad Gita. No, Krishna, of course, he demands. That is his great mercy. He is demanding in Bhagavad Gita that use your senses in my service. He is declaring it. And he is telling that if you use your senses in serving me, then you will become happy. So that is his great mercy. But actually, our senses, our own self, it must be used in his service because it belongs to him only. So he is the master. That's why he is Rishikesh. His name is Rishikesh. The living entities are part and parcel of him. And therefore, the senses of the living entities are also part and parcel of his senses. The living entities are part and parcel of Krishna. Amsha mamaiva amsha jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatan. So we are Ansha of the Supreme Lord. Similarly, our senses are also Amsha or part and parcel of his senses. The impersonalist cannot account for the senses of the living entities, and therefore they are always anxious to describe all living entities as senseless or impersonal. So Mayavadis or impersonalists, they cannot understand that the living entities have spiritual senses and the Lord has also our spiritual senses. That's why they think that living entities and the Lord are senseless. So this is because of their senselessness, that they think that living entities and the Supreme Lord is senseless. This is their senselessness. They cannot sense this thing because they have no sense to sense that living entities also have senses and Krishna also have senses. But our senses and Krishna's senses are not material. The body also has got senses, but bodily senses are material senses. And it is temporary. But living entities, the soul's senses and Krishna's senses are spiritual in nature. If the dead matter can have sense, why can't the living spiritual spark have sense? What is this logic? If something which is made up of dead material object and material elements, earth, water, fire, air, ether, if it can possess sense, sensory functions, sense means it can sense something. It has the ability to take the input and ability to give the output. That is the meaning of senses. We have five working senses and five knowledge acquiring senses. So knowledge acquiring senses means taking input from the surrounding external world. And working senses means giving output to the external world. So if the dull matter, material elements, earth, water, fire, air, ether, if the combination made of these dull matters, which appears like this body, if it can have sense, if it can also possess sensory functions, so why can't the soul and the supreme soul, who are living personalities, why shouldn't they have senses? What is this nonsense? Prabhupada says this. So this is their nonsensical thought, whose Mayavadis. They think that the soul and super soul have not got any senses, and after liberation, everything just merges into and becomes one. Everything just merges in Brahman, and Brahman has got no senses. Brahma cannot see, cannot eat, cannot hear, cannot walk, cannot talk. This is their Brahma actually. Brahman, Param Brahma and Jiva Brahma. Two types of Brahma are there. So Param Brahma and the Jeev Brahma, Anu Brahma, both of them can talk, can walk, can see, can hear, and can do all the sensory functions. Only in Brahma or illusion, only in Brahma, the Mayavadis or impersonalist, Nirakarvadi, they think that Brahman cannot have senses. So this is there, and this is illogical because nowhere in the scriptures their theory is supported. Rather, the other way is supported. In the Vedanta Sutra, they are very fond of studying Vedanta philosophy, Upanishad, Vedas, Vedanta philosophy they study. The very first Sutra of the Vedanta philosophy states, Janamadiyasya yataha. Everything is coming out of the Supreme Absolute Truth, Param Brahma. Say, if Supreme Absolute Truth giving out everything, so how can it be senseless? That means senses are there, working senses are there, he is working. Otherwise, how is it that the something output is coming out? If I am giving some output, that means I have senses. So the Supreme Lord has got senses. And another sutra is there. So many sutras are there. Anna Anandamaya Abhyasat. This is another Vedanta sutra in which it is explained that Absolute Truth, Param Brahma, he is always Anandamaya Abhyasat. He is always engaged. Abhyasat means he is always engaged in the activities of bliss. Anandamaya. Anandamaya. Anandamaya Leela Maya Vigrahaya. This is another verse in Chaitanya Chandrodaya Natak. Prabhudananda Saraswati Thakur writes about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But in Vedanta Sutra also it is mentioned. Anandamaya Abhyasat. The Absolute Truth, Param Brahma, is the personality who is always engaged in blissful activities. So if the Param Brahma is engaged in activities of performing bliss, then how can he be senseless? How can he be impersonal, nirakar? It does not make any sense. And he cannot be impersonal, he must be person. Because only a person can engage in activities, only a person can give some output. So all these Vedanta Sutra, they also, everything proves. Another sutra is raso vai saha, saha means that Supreme Absolute Truth. Saha means in Sanskrit, the meaning of sa or saha is he. He refers to a person. So saha means a person. Already in the Vedanta Sutra, it is referred that the Supreme Brahman, Absolute Truth, is a person. So how can you say it is in nirakar? Nirakar cannot be a person. Person means it has got a form. He has got a form. And that too, in this verse, it is explained, raso vaisaha. Raso means he is the abode of all kinds of mellows or rasa. Means he has all kinds of emotions. Rasa means emotions. Like we have emotions. We have, means we have friends and relatives, parents, husband, wife. So we have got different rasas. Different emotions. We can sometimes we become angry with them. Sometimes we become very happy. Sometimes we become very grateful to them. Sometimes we love them. Sometimes we chastise them. Sometimes we make distance from them. We are not inclined to talk to them. So these different kinds of rasas are there. Emotions. Rasa means emotions. And different varieties of emotions, they generate different kinds of bliss. Of course, in the material world, all these different kinds of emotions, instead of giving bliss, they give suffering. And because of this reason, these Mayavadis, they try to negate all kinds of emotions, spiritual emotions. They think that if at all there are emotions in the spiritual world, it must also be a painful situation. So that's why, in fear of, this is the condition of fearfulness. So in fear of getting again into painful situation, Mayavadis, they think that in spiritual life also, there must not be any kind of emotions. It must be emotionless, no rasa, it must be dry, impersonal, nothing, no existence, no senses, no activities. So this is their misconception. This is their mental speculation, because they study Vedanta Sutra. In the sutra, it is very nicely explained. Raso vaisaha, Supreme Absolute Truth is full of rasa. So many emotions are there, and we know The supreme absolute truth, Krishna is a Param Brahma. Arjuna says, Param Brahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan. My dear Krishna, you are Param Brahma. You are Param Dhamma. Param Brahma means supreme absolute truth. You are Param Dhamma. You are resting abode of all the creations, all the living entities. Param Brahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram. You are the purest of all pure. Pavitram, Paramam Bhavan. Paramam means you are supreme. You are supreme of all the living entities. So Arjuna declares in the Bhagavad Gita that Krishna is the supreme absolute truth. And the same thing has been declared by Srila Vyasadeva in Bhagavatam. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Janamadiyashriyataha. And then he explains, goes on explaining his activities. And at the end he says, Satyam Paramadhimahi. Satyam Paramadhimahi. Satyam Param. Param Satyam means supreme absolute truth. And that is supreme Param Brahma. And who is that supreme Param Brahma? Supreme absolute truth, that is Vasudeva. Om Namo Bhagavate. Bhagavate means Bhagavan. Bhagavan means who possesses opulences. He is not opulenceless. He has opulences and he is Vasudev, the son of Vasudev or Krishna. So Krishna is Param Brahma. It has been established. This conclusion has been established in all the Vedic literatures. Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Samhita, Upanishad, Puranas, everywhere. This has been established. It is an established truth. Nobody can deny it. Those people who are having poor fund of knowledge out of envy, they decline. They deny this very fact. And they say, absolute truth has no form. Krishna has got material form. All these bogus things they speak. But Param Brahma has got form. And Param Brahma, Raso Vaisaha, he is the abode of all kinds of emotions. And we see Krishna is having so many different varieties of living entities. His pure devotees, he has got a unique relationship with each and every living entity. So Krishna has got unlimited varieties of rasa. He is Raso Vaisaha means he is rasa agar. He is khan. He is mine of all kinds of rasa. Krishna, the reservoir of all pleasure. Prabhupada has written one very small booklet. Krishna, the reservoir of all pleasure. He is reservoir of all kinds of rasa. He has all kinds of emotions. Whatever exists in the material world and whatever does not exist in the material world is all present in the personality of Krishna. So Krishna has got unlimited number of pure devotees and which each and every living entity, Krishna has got a unique relationship. And that unique relationship gives, it generates a unique kind of rasa, mellow, in which the Supreme Lord Krishna himself and the living entity, both of them, they enjoy this rasa. Previous acharyas, great acharyas, they have analyzed these different kinds of relationships and they have categorized it into total number 12 relationships. And out of which 5 are primary relationships and 7 are considered secondary relationships. 5 primary relationships or rasas are with Krishna are Vatsalya Rasa, Madhuri Rasa or Singar Rasa also, Vatsalya Rasa and Sakya Rasa, Dasya Rasa, Santarasa. These 5 are primary relationships, primary rasas. But in this each one of the category, there are unlimited variety also. But this is category. So anyway, so the point is Krishna is Raso Vaisaha. This is another Vedic aphorism. Another Vedanta Sutra, it is mentioned. Sa Aikshata. When he wanted to create this material existence, for the purpose of creating this material existence, Sa Aikshata. Aikshata means he glanced upon material nature. Bhautik Prakriti. He glanced upon material nature. And because of the glance of the Supreme Lord, Param Brahma, Krishna, the material nature, Prakriti, she becomes pregnant with all kinds of living entities. That is the process of impregnating the material nature. Just like a husband impregnates his wife to bear a child, and over the period of time she becomes pregnant and she gives birth to a child. Similarly, द सुप्रीम पुरुषा, द सुप्रीम हस्बैंड और पुरुषा, द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड नारायण सा एक्षता इन द वेदांत सूत्र इट इज मेंशन. सो ही ऑल्सो इम्प्रेगनेट्स, बट हिज इम्प्रेगनेशन प्रोसेस इज नॉट लाइक द इम्प्रेगनेशन बाय ऑर्डनरी हस्बैंड टू द वाइफ, बिकॉज ही सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड, ही इज ओमनीपोटेंट. सो विदाउट इवन टचिंग द मटेरियल नेचर प्रकृति, ही हैज गॉट द पावर सिंपली बाय ग्लैंसिंग, सिंपली बाय सीइंग दृष्टिपात, सिंपली बाय ग्लैंसिंग ही इम्प्रेगनेट्स ऑल अन इन्यूमरेबल लिविंग एंटिटीज विद इन द वूम्ब ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर. तो जस्ट सी इन दिस सूत्र ऑल्सो इट इज सो वेरी नाइसली एक्सप्लेन दैट ही इज अ पर्सन, ही इज अ पुरुष हु इम्प्रेगनेट्स द प्रकृति. सो हाउ कैन ही बी इम्पर्सनल, निराकार? वेर इज द क्वेश्चन? वॉट इज दिस नॉन सेंस? हु से दैट परम ब्रह्मा इज निराकार? परम ब्रह्मा हैज गॉट नो आईज, नो लेग्स, नो ईयर्स, नो माउथ, नथिंग. ही कैन नॉट टॉक, ही कैन नॉट वॉक, ही कैन नॉट हियर, ही कैन नॉट टेस्ट. वॉट टू स्पीक ऑफ टेस्टिंग, हियरिंग, सीइंग, वॉकिंग, टॉकिंग? द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड हैज गॉट द एबिलिटी टू हैव सेक्स ऑल्सो, बट हिज वे ऑफ डूइंग सेक्स इज डिफरेंट इन द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड. दैट इज डिफरेंट. बट कृष्णा ऑल्सो ही इम्प्रेगनेट्स द मटेरियल नेचर बाय सिंपली बाय सीइंग ही डज दिस टास्क. सो इफ कृष्णा कैन डू ऑल दीज फंक्शंस, सो हाउ कैन ही बी कॉल्ड एज इम्पर्सन? हाउ कैन समबडी से दैट कृष्णा द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड गॉड इज निराकार, इम्पर्सनल? नो, ही इज अ पर्सन. ही हैज गॉट ऑल द फीलिंग्स, रादर ही हैज गॉट ऑल द फीलिंग्स. वी आर जस्ट पार्ट एंड पार्सल. वी हैव गॉट सम लिटिल फीलिंग्स, इमोशंस, एंड इन मटेरियल वर्ल्ड दीज इमोशंस आर जस्ट परवर्टेडली रिफ्लेक्टेड. दैट्स वाई इट हैज गॉट टेम्परेरीनेस एंड इट रिजल्ट इन टू मिजरेबल सिचुएशन. बट इन द स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड कृष्णा एंड हिज डिवोटीज ऑल्सो हैव गॉट अ वेरी नाइस वंडरफुल रिलेशनशिप, एंड दे हैव गॉट वेरी नाइस वंडरफुल इमोशनल इमोशंस ऑल्सो, भाव. बट दोज इमोशंस आर नॉट मटेरियल इमोशंस, दोज इमोशंस आर परमानेंट, इटरनल, स्पिरिचुअल, फैक्चुअल इमोशंस, नोन एज भाव, रसा, ऑल्सो नोन एज रसा, स्पिरिचुअल रसा. So like that, I have just quoted few of the Vedant Sutras, but there are so many Vedic mantras, Upanishads, and Vedant Sutras where this fact has been proven that Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead, and he has also got all kinds of activities, all kinds of relationships. He has also got the rasas. He also has some likings and dislikings. He also has got emotions, feelings. He also wants something. He also does not want something. It's not that he is senseless. No, he also desires. He also likes something. He also has got some favorite item to eat. He has also got some hobby. What is that hobby? Surabhi Rabipalayantam Lakshmi Sahasrasata Sambhram Chintamani Prakarasatma Sukalpavriksha लक्षावृते सुसुरभिरभिपालयन्तं लक्ष्मीसहस्रशतसम्भ्रमसेव्यमानं गोविन्दमादिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि. इन ब्रह्म संहिता लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा एक्सप्लेन्स दैट कृष्णा ही इज अ कॉवर्ड बॉय, दैट इज हिज फेवरेट पास्ट टाइम, बीइंग अ कॉवर्ड बॉय एंड टू टेक द काउज. शुभ सुरभि अभिपालयन्तं, कृष्णा लाइक्स इट वेरी मच टू प्रोटेक्ट टू टेक द काउज फॉर ग्रेजिंग इन द फील्ड. दैट इज हिज फेवरेट हॉबी. सो ही ऑल्सो हैज गॉट दिस हॉबी, जस्ट लाइक एनी बॉय, एनी गर्ल और बॉय, दे हैव गॉट सम हॉबी. दैट अ बॉय लाइक्स टू प्ले क्रिकेट, अ गर्ल लाइक्स टू कुक इन द किचन. ऑफकोर्स नाउ डेज इट मे नॉट बी सो. अ गर्ल सी डजेंट लाइक टू कुक इन द किचन, एंड अ बॉय डजेंट लाइक टू play cricket. A boy wants to just play in the video game. But anyway, whatever it may be, but earlier days, a boy, his hobby was to go out and play and to have fun with friends, to show his heroic activity, adventurous activities. But nowadays, the boys have become, they just live within the house, and girls, they are going out and showing their activities. So everything is going on. Everything has become topsy-turvy. सब उल्टा पुल्टा हो गया है. बट एनी वे द मेन पॉइंट वॉज वॉट आई वॉज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट Just like anybody in this material world has got some hobby. Similarly, the Supreme Lord Krishna, he is also a person. So he has also got hobby. He has also got liking, disliking. So he also wants something from us. So what does he want? That he explains in Bhagavad Gita. That will be covered in the coming sessions. Okay. So I think time is up. We just started this purport. Only one line we could read. Tomorrow we'll complete it. Hare Krishna. So thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Is there any question?
तो प्रभु जी, एक छोटी सी कमेंट ऐड करनी थी कि आजकल के लोग खाना पकाते तो नहीं है, ना ही रॉ वेजिटेबल्स या ना ही फ्रूट्स खाते हैं, जबकि ऑर्डर एक हाई कोर्ट या सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जज से ज़्यादा करती है। हरे कृष्णा,
सही बात। ओके,
दंडवत प्रणाम।
हरे कृष्ण। यस, और किसी भक्त का कोई प्रश्न है? एनी क्वेश्चन?